It's Danny Starr. The new year kicked off with a whole lot of drama, so it's only right we take a look back on what happened this week in Hollywood. After spending 90 days in the Betty Ford Clinic, Lindsay Lohan finally made it out of rehab. She's done with treatment and she moved into her new house. The only problem with that is it's directly next door to her ex-girlfriend Samantha Ronson. Talk about drama. Samantha Ronson was super heated about the whole situation, but apparently they have now worked it out. All I know is that had to be planned. Out of all the houses in Venice, California, that's the one you choose? Mm-hmm. Come on, Lindsay. But we do wish her the best of luck in 2011. Rapper T.I. got into a little bit of trouble this week, and I know what you're thinking. Isn't he in jail? How did he get in trouble? Well, that's exactly where he did get into trouble. Now, he is serving an 11-month sentence, and you can have visitors, of course. So, who comes to visit him? His wife, Tiny. Here's the issue. Now, when you go to visit someone in jail, you can embrace them, hug them, kiss them, but only at the beginning and end of each visit. During the visit, Tiny decided to take matters into her own hands. Literally, under the table. She's trying to do something for T.I. If you know what I'm trying to say, just follow along here. I don't want to get too graphic. Now, they're obviously caught, reprimanded. T.I. gets sent to pretty much solitary confinement. Tiny's like, hey, I wanted to please my man, I'm sorry. But you know what? As T.I. was walking to solitary confinement, I bet he was thinking, man, that was worth it. After a whirlwind romance, Taylor Swift and Jake Gyllenhaal have called it quits. Now, this is really sad for them, but this is really awesome for us because this means we're gonna get one killer song about Jake Gyllenhaal. I mean, seriously, what guy has Taylor Swift dated that she hasn't written a song about? Oh, yes. I'm ready for the Jake Gyllenhaal song. Now, they're saying that it had something to do with their ages. She's 19, he's 30. But a lot of people say, you know what? Jake Gyllenhaal couldn't handle the publicity. He wanted his relationship to be private, and that's not gonna happen when you're dating Taylor Swift. Either way, good music is coming, people, so we'll keep you posted. Okay, I've been saying this for months now. Bieber fever is no joke. Justin Bieber decided to take a little romantic getaway to the island of St. Lucia, and who does he bring with him? The lovely Selena Gomez. Now, obviously, they're dating. I don't care if they keep denying it, I'm gonna say it right here, right now. Justin Bieber and Selena Gomez are dating. Problem. Not only are they dating, but they're being very affectionate, and of course the pictures wound up on the internet, leading to hundreds of death threats for Selena Gomez, and now the FBI is actually investigating some of Justin Bieber's fans. Oh my goodness, Bieber fever people, no joke. Be careful, Selena, beef up the security. The Michael Jackson pre-hearing happened this week in Hollywood, and basically what it is the trial before the trial. Now, a judge is hearing reasons why Dr. Conrad Murray should actually go to trial and be charged with involuntary manslaughter. Now, the prosecution is expected to bring 30 witnesses. The trial is supposed to last about 2 weeks, and already the whole Jackson family has been there. We've got Mother Catherine, Sister Janet showed up, Brother Jackie. There's going to be a lot of stuff that comes out about this whole Michael Jackson death, and we will definitely keep you posted as breaking news happens. Last but not least, the People's Choice Awards happened this week, and I was super excited. First of all, Queen Latifah did an amazing job hosting, but my favorite award of the night was Best TV Guilty Pleasure. Now, for the longest time, I've been thinking, I'm super obsessed with the Kardashians, but I'm not the only one. The people chose Kim, Courtney, and Khloe as their best TV guilty pleasure. And people, if you have not kept up with the Kardashians, you are sincerely missing out. But of course, the show must go on. There was a ton of more artists, a ton of more awards, and so much more details. They're all over at the website, bittenandbound.com, so make sure you head over there. I'm Danny Starr for bittenandbound.com, showing you the not-so-pretty side of Hollywood.